There's a lot of debate on YouTube around what's better, Zapier or Make. Well, you might be surprised to find out I use both. I have a Zapier account and I have a Make account because sometimes there are triggers that Zapier has that Make doesn't have. Here's an example. I'm on the Make website and I want to find the YouTube module that Make has. Well, that's disappointing. So in this case, what I would do is I would go over to Zapier and I would watch the YouTube channel that I want to trigger from. And then I'm going to actually send the data over to Make to finish my automation. And that's what I'm going to show you in this video. My name is Andy O'Neill and I help entrepreneurs like you add automation to their business. I want to encourage you to click the link in the description to join my newsletter. And please give this a thumbs up and subscribe if this is a video that you were looking for and it's helpful to you. All right, I'm over here in Zapier. I have a brand new Zap opened up, and I'm going to try this new powered by AI thing to see if it can pre-build this scenario for me. Okay, I've just typed in a simple sentence here. Create a Zap that watches a YouTube channel for a new video and sends that data to a webhook. Let's click generate and see what happens. This is promising. Notify YouTube videos via webhook. So here is a new video and channel. Step two is post to webhooks by Zapier. This is perfect. So I'm going to click try it. Now we need to configure the steps in our Zap. So I'm going to choose my account. So next I need the channel ID. So I'm going to go to the channel first. Let's find the ID for this. So I'm going to do a little Google search. Right here, YouTube channel ID, you can see I've used this in the past, so I'm going to click that there. I'm going to copy the URL of my YouTube channel. And you got to go down past the ads. And we're going to put that in there. Let's do 15. All right, there we go. Here is the channel ID, and this is what Zapier wants here. Now you'll notice my YouTube handle is at automate your business. That is not the YouTube ID. And if you put that in there, the Zap won't run correctly. So I'm going to copy that channel ID and I'm going to paste that right there and continue. Now let's test the trigger. We have some test data that was returned and this is the last video I published. So that's good. I'm going to say continue with selected record. Next, we're going to set up our webhook post to Make. And so what we're going to do here is we need a URL and let's go over to Make and set that up. All right. I've created a new scenario in Make and let's click here and say webhooks and webhook. And we want a custom webhook. I'm going to rename this before I go any further. So I'm going to copy this. I like to make my webhook names the same as my scenario name, so they're easy to match up. I can like add, paste, and save. And then I'm going to copy my webhook. I'm going to hit OK, and I'm going to say run once, just so it's ready to go. Now I'm going to go back over here. I'm back in Zapier on my webhook step, and I'm going to paste the webhook right there. And the payload type is form. And basically, I'm not going to touch anything else here. The reason is if I map any data, I would have to map everything or the things that I want. If you don't map any data, it will send it all. And that's what I want to do. So I'm going to click continue, scroll down here, and I'm going to click test step. Now if we go back to Make, we have data. So here's the channel ID. Here's the title. Here's the description of the video. So what I would normally do is continue building right here on this Make scenario, but I'm going to stop right here because the point of this video was to show you how to get data from Zapier to Make so you could build your complex scenarios in Make. And what this also does is it keeps your Zapier bill down because back here we just have a two-step Zap. That's more economical than building everything in Zapier. That's what I typically do. I keep my Zapier account to the smallest one I possibly can. And so it keeps that bill down and I do the other stuff in Make. If this was interesting and you want to see how I sent data from Bardeen, which is a web-based automation tool, over to Make, then check out this video and you can see exactly how I did that step by step. I'll see you next time.